I just got an AMG 6.
Money amazing, but when it's too much, get amazed. She wanna down and cost me off. She gonna put me in close.
Sorry, I'm a dog bag. Daughter, I don't know. LAX with bad bitches. Honey, you had like a trash trip. Sorry, I mean to play, babe. Ian Lane, Lonnie, Hunter. Sorry. Oh, I'm gonna go to New York. Oh, she wanna down and cost me off. Oh, yo, good YouTube, we back with another video. Y'all gotta make like a little squad name for y'all niggas, for y'all young bulls, you know what I'm saying? We gotta get a name. Drop some ideas down below in the comment section. We gotta get some names, like, for me, so we can come in and take over 2024, nigga. Wow. Let me stop. But yo, anyways, we have a reaction video today. The problem with black YouTube. I know I might be a little bit late with this one. And I swear I didn't watch it. I just kept seeing people react to it. Like, by people, I mean T-Banks. I see T-Banks, shout out T-Banks. I seen T-Banks react to it. But I was like, oh shit, hold on, before I finish it. Every time I see something I feel like I should react to, I don't finish it. So I started some of it, but I didn't finish the whole thing because I wanted to finish the reaction. So now we're here and we got the problem with black YouTube. I know he was cooking, because there is a very big problem with black YouTube. And my personal take on it, I feel like most of these niggas is just out here doing it for the guap. Because they see people like Quan. It's really ATL. I'm going to be honest. Atlanta ruined authentic YouTube. Because it's really, look, the cover page is at an Atlanta nigga. It's a Southern nigga. I'm on it. Like, don't get me wrong. I fuck with the Atlanta niggas. But y'all really ruined YouTube, like.
Rubbing my brick on my friend to how she reacts. She touched it. What the fuck?
There's a
hold on. Up the quality on this shit.
There's a problem with YouTube, specifically black YouTube. Black YouTube sucks. When it comes to black YouTube, I feel like there's two sides. There's one side with these amazing content creators like Corey X Kenshin, Verleezy, AMP, RDC, and many others. And then you got this other side with these creators that don't care about their content at all. All they care about is the money that comes with YouTube, and all their videos are just based around sexual things. One side is...
I'm not gonna say in cap. I tried it, and it's not the bop. That's what I gotta say.
That homemade burger that takes hours to make, and the other side is like that $2 McDonald's burger that tastes good for about 5 minutes, but the next day you feel like absolute. It's kind of like yin and yang, you know? And in today's video, I'm going to be talking about that other side of black YouTube, the terrible side. Now, when it comes to the black community and content creation, I feel like every single idea can't just be a normal idea, you know? There always has to be some sort of sexual spin to it. You can't just do a normal truth or dare. It has to be a freaky truth or dare. You can't just go in a...
Every nigga on that clip right there was... God, bro, you don't have a stutter, bro. What the fuck is wrong with you? Damn.
Can't just be a normal idea, you know? Watch. There always has to be some sort of sexual
pay close
spin.
Attention.
You can't just do a normal truth or dare. It has to be a freaky truth.
Yeah, I already know all of them. Look at they. It's all Atlanta niggas, bro. I'm telling y'all. I don't know. I don't know. That's a hard take. Everybody from Atlanta probably gonna hate me for this. This is a hard take. But I feel like most of the content creators that you see it's stereotypical to say this, but most of them that you see doing this are tall dreadheads with tattoos. And where are they usually from? Atlanta. Come on, bro. Fall back off the Johnson. Please don't Johnson me for that. That's bad Johnson.
Johnson means dick rod. That's the new word. Chill.
Just going a blind date, it has to be a freaky blind date. The other day, I literally seen a video titled
I'm not gonna lie, Booba. What? Nah, but Booba is super tough with it though, because Booba really bought, like, he kind of took what Kai did, but really, like, because Kai was, like, doing the features with the rappers and shit, he took what Kai did and he took off with it. Like, he, boom, like, boom. And how Booba does it though, it's like, like I said, it's okay to do it one time. Like, Booba did it, like, a couple times. He probably had, like, 2-3 videos of it. And then, like, other shit is actual funny content, like him trolling rappers or him with Rella, actual vlogs or doing pranks in public. Like, he's actually a YouTuber. He's not just, oh, nah, how can I get them? Let me get the quick views. Let me do a view glitch and just, oh, freaky truth or dare, I put my blick in her mouth.
I put my freaky ass parents on a blind date. We are getting to the point in content creation where we're putting our parents on blind dates and it has to be freaky. That is absolutely weird.
I think after this part, I didn't see
another trend that's pretty big in the black community are 20v1s. These videos hit the black community harder than crack in the 80s.
But the way Jubilee does it and Sidemen does it is tough.
Tell you how many black content creators I've seen milking the absolute life out of 20.
Every person you're about to see right here is from the South. Guan, Annalie Choppa.
Now, if you don't know what a 20v1 is, well, it's crazy. Basically like a speed dating show.
Those were tough. But now it's just used for a money glitch. And that's another money glitch right there. You just get on, you turn on the camera, you find some semi-famous nigga and then get 20 bitches and you're gonna get mad views. But it's not authentic, so why would you want that? You know what I'm saying?
Where 20 people speed date one person, and by the end of the show, that one person picks their favorite out of the 20 people. I'm pretty sure this video idea was like created by Jubilee, popularized by the Sidemen, and then the black community just took it by storm. Now don't get me wrong, there are some genuinely funny 20v1s out there, but then you got channels out here who are posting 20v1s every single week. For example, No Love Mar. Now if you don't know who No Love Mar is, well, he's a pretty big black YouTuber who has 1.44 million subscribers. But when you take a look at this man's channel, basically all of his videos are 20v1s. I wouldn't be surprised if this man changed his name to Cupid, the way he's helping out everyone find love. I wouldn't be surprised if this man did a 20v1 with the whole entire United States for his next video. Honestly, at this point, this man should put me in a 20v1 to help me find some
ass. Yeah! Fuck, this nigga's head is so fucking big, bro.
Like, come on. And what's crazy is that this man is so obsessed with 20v1s that he literally jumped another YouTuber because they made a 20v1 with Krishan Rock and he wanted to do that idea first. I mean, there's literally entire videos of him and his crew just pulling up to their studio, them beating up the other guys, and them taking the camera and the footage so it doesn't get uploaded.
Nah!
Number one.
What? Nah, niggas crashed out. What? Niggas crashed out on him like that? It's none of that. Niggas slide to the spot and take my... It's... Word to my deads, it's none of that. If niggas slide to my spot, take my camera and break me down, I'm flipping the whole Atlanta over. It's none of that. I'm blowing up the spot. I swear to God, in GTA RP, I'm blowing the whole shit up, yo. In GTA RP.
Happen to shame? Who genuinely wants to speed date the snaggletooth demon Krishan Rock? That woman is literally the embodiment of a Neanderthal. And number two, yeah, why are you out here jumping other YouTubers? Johnson. Because they're about to upload an idea before you. Just be more creative and make something other than 20v1s. And maybe you wouldn't have to resort to jumping people because they make the same style of content as you. Imagine if Moist Critical got to a topic before me and I fought him because of that. Isn't that the stupidest thing ever? Like, it just doesn't make sense at all. And what's even worse is that before every 20v1 that this man does, he promotes this scam where apparently you're supposed to get 750.
Yo, I'm glad he mentioned this, yo. I'm glad he mentioned this, bro. This is the oldest. If you still fall for this and you get scammed, you deserve it. You deserve. I don't care if the nigga. I don't care if he pulls your SSN. If you fall for this in 2024, you deserve everything coming for you. I don't care. Why the fuck would Cash App just give $750 to anybody? Niggas be up right now. That don't even make sense. Like, I don't even gotta speak too much about this. I'm pretty sure y'all all know this. The claim your reward shit. When niggas used to hit me up on that shit, like when it first came out and people used to hit me up, it was none of that. I used to get vexed when I saw that. I'm like, yo, bro, stop playing with me, bro. I'm gonna break you down for sending this shit again.
There's Cash App from clicking the link in the description, but you don't. It just takes you to one of those sites where they have you fill out all of those tedious surveys and you get nothing from them. I mean, there's literally entire videos on YouTube exposing these scams. He gets the money because he gets paid from people clicking the link, but you as a viewer, you get nothing because, I mean, why would Cash App just give you $750? They would be broke if they just decided to do that. It just shows how greedy of a YouTuber this man is, but I'm pretty sure that was already pretty evident. You also have this other YouTuber right here named RealXShawn. And basically a bunch of his videos are just 20v1s. I mean, nothing really else. But this man also, he spams that link in the description with that $750 Cash App that you're never gonna get. And then you got another 20v1 YouTuber right here named Ryan with the Sauce, and he also spams that link in the description with that $750 Cash App. And what's also crazy about these 20v1 YouTubers is that
you see what I'm talking about, bro, and they're all from the South, bro. Like, I think so. I'm not sure about Sean, whatever the fuck his name is. But I know Ryan with the Sauce and Lamar. Definitely, they're Southern niggas. And, like, I don't know. It's, like, it's just a wave. Like, it's literally, like, I don't know, bro. They all get money. Don't get me wrong. They still get money. But they're ruining, like, Black YouTube communities. Because now it's, like, I don't know. I don't know. I hope this wave dies out and niggas just go back to authentic, the Roman Atwood, Corey X, Kenshin, keep AMP, keep Jubilee, keep Sidemen. Those days, Corey X, Kenshin, those days of YouTube were sweet. Now it's like, it's anything. I don't even know what this shit is anymore.
No originality with any of them. The only difference is the people in the 20v1s. The intros are all the same. The editing is all the same. Hell, even the freaking personalities of all these YouTubers are all the same. Even the freaking scam in the video. They're all doing the same $750 Cash App scam. Even the scam in the video is the exact same. These dudes are literally made in a freaking laboratory, bro. Like, they're just printed every single freaking week. Every week, I see a new up-and-coming 20v1 YouTuber. What's also crazy is that these dudes will have young facts in their 20v1s, which is very sad. For you guys that don't,
what do you mean by that? What do you mean by that? Young people.
Well, there's this rapper named La Tyler, and he's 17 years old. And the YouTuber No Love Mar, he made a video with La Tyler. Matter, he made a 20v1, and it's disgusting, if I'm being honest with you.
How you feel about for tonight?
I don't think it's bad. Like, if both of y'all vibing with each other, you peep the vibe. We grown.
There's a bunch of grown women in there asking a 17-year-old if he's husband material, which that's completely wild to me. I mean, the man's not even college material. He's not even past high school. What do you mean, is he husband material? That's just
odd. Yeah, but I feel like
you can't.
He's a rapper, though, so I don't. It don't really matter.
17 is close to 18, but at the end of the day, if you sleep with a 17-year-old, that is illegal. But what's even crazier is that there's 20v1s with Lil RT, and for y'all
that's know, crazy.
Lil RT is a 9-year-old. No,
hold on, hold on.
But he's not
on,
like the main
hold
character.
On, hold on, shut the fuck up. That right there, that's crazy. I'm not gonna lie. This nigga is 3. He is 3. Yo, nah. That right there was crazy. I'm not gonna lie. When I saw that, that was crazy. I don't...
Do what you gotta do. Do what you gotta do. If you need to do that to get the views, to get the guap up, okay. Do it.
I'm not saying nothing, but I know for a fact that that is not right.
...ones. He's like that little assist character that you have in freaking Mortal Kombat when you spam L1. I mean, as you can see right here, there's literally a video called I Found Love from the help of Lil RT. Why do you need a 9-year-old to help you find love? You also got the YouTuber King Sid, who's also been doing many videos with Lil RT, and he's not doing them in like the right way.
Lil RT, IBBW.
Promoting
what's the guys? They ain't nothing. We fucking bitch shit. Bad it doesn't.
Mom. In the whole video, this that's man is crazy. Literally just cursing and everything right in front of his mom, which is pretty crazy. If I would have cursed in front of my mom, I wouldn't be here making this video today, if I'm being real with you. No but bad. Yeah, I just find it odd how these guys literally have videos and the whole idea of the video is to sexualize a
young person.
I mean, that's just gotta pretty stop crazy. Saying that, though. Another that's style crazy. Of content that's pretty big in the black community is face-to-face smasher passes, which these videos are also pretty unbearable to watch. If you don't know what this is, well, it's basically a bunch of grown adults getting lined up, and one by one, they basically go through these lines and say smash or pass to the person they're standing right in front of. It's pretty sad when you really think about it. If I had to sit here and watch this for 30...
Hold on. Let me speak my piece. Let me speak my piece. My camera... Now, let me speak my piece, though. When they first came out, they were fire. And a couple months after that, it was still fire. Right now, I will never watch a smash or pass. I barely watch YouTube now. I probably watch Kai Snow occasionally because you're going to see him everywhere. It's hard not to watch a nigga. I really just be watching T-Banks. I still watch Soluminati. A little bit of Deshae Frost and Dub. That's really all I watch, though. If I'm on YouTube, if I'm watching YouTubers, if I'm on YouTube, I'm 9 times out of 10, I'm spending my time watching like cars or some shit, like, or like how to edit or, and like, you feel me, informational shit. I'm not about to sit here and waste my time like watching other niggas. You know what I'm saying? Watching the winning niggas, you're gonna lose. But, the Smasher Pass, I tried that in my previous old YouTube channel. It's not the bop. That shit was not for me. I'm not. It's none of that. I'm not gonna lie. It's none of that. I'm not jacking none of that. Yeah.
I'm not gonna lie, I probably wouldn't even make it through. I would lose freaking all my brain cells by the 5th minute of this video. But yeah, that's another style of content with black YouTube that's pretty stupid in my opinion. I mean,
imagine you open your phone, right? And you scrolling through Instagram, you chilling, you having a good day, drinking, you feel me, you drinking at Casamigos. You're chilling, right? You start scrolling through. And you go on King Sid shit. And you zoom in. And you see a bitch doing a smash her pass. Because the nigga was in her DMs like, yo, I give you 3K, you could hop in this video, do a smasher pass. And then she pulls up with fucking, with a sexy Christmas outfit. I'm going in that building. And I'm not going to say too much because I might get word. I'm going on that building and everyone is going to regret having her in there. No cap. That's all I have to say.
Giving birth to a child just for them to participate in a face-to-face smasher pass. And like I said earlier, a lot of black YouTube, their content just revolves around just extremely horny content. Public interviews. I mean, you know, the whole gay son or thought daughter thing. Find your match, which is just basically they get a room full of people and they just try to find their matches and stuff. Overall, my problem with black YouTube is that, number one, it's just unoriginal. Everybody's just copying off each other and expecting to become the biggest black YouTuber of all time with zero originality, which is absolutely crazy. And number two, all these videos are just based around
that's kind of you know, you doing public videos, if you doing public interviews above the age of 21, put down the camera and immediately go on Indeed immediately and fill out that application. Because I'm going to get mad. I'm going to get very mad if a nigga come up to me and be like, yo, swap phones. It's none of that. I'm not swapping phones. It's none of that. What? Box. I'm going to break you down. Talking about some goddamn swap phones. I know she cheating, nigga. I don't trust bitches. I just take the risk.
Sexual concepts for kids to click on them, and then once these kids click on them, they're just going to freaking promote these little scams and stuff, like the $750 Cash App scam, just so they can get paid. Overall, black YouTube is just down atrocious right now, and it's honestly sad to see, bro. But yeah, this is gonna wrap up the video. If you guys made this far, I appreciate you. If you guys enjoyed this video, then I highly recommend you guys check out my most recent video. It'll be somewhere up here on the screen. But yeah, with all that being said, thank you guys for watching.
All right, that concludes the video. I agree. He cooked the whole time. I don't think anything he said. I wonder what made him sit at home and really say, yo, let me just go off on black YouTubers. Like, he must have been fed up with some shit. Something must have happened. But I agree with everything he said. I have nothing to say. I can say though, at first when it was first starting up, like the smasher pass, the face-to-face shit, all of that shit, when it was first heating up, I cannot tell a lie. It was tough. But now it's like, all right, bro, come on. Like when King said first brought that shit about for, on the black side, it was wavy. Then niggas was just like, all right, you spamming it. And then it just got like overplayed. And now niggas is just doing it for a money glitch. So, yeah, that shit is whack now. But it's soft corn. Corn, YouTube corn. Soft corn. Cause that's like the little young niggas that get no cheeks. It's a pandemic of niggas that get no ass. So they like to go on YouTube and see like bubble butt women and Christmas outfits. Niggas is, and then you got like a D1 athlete pull up on her and smack her cheeks and it ripples the earth. Like, I don't know. They like to see that because they don't get no ass in the real world. So they just sit behind a screen and they're meat warriors. So, I don't know. That's my take on it. Like, I agree with him. But I ain't, without further ado, yo, I love y'all. If y'all made it this far, I love you guys. Even if y'all didn't, still love you. For the people that I don't even know, we climbing. Road to 100 subscribers. You know what I'm saying? Turn on your post notifications. Like, comment, subscribe. More social medias in the bio down below. You feel what I'm saying? Without further ado,